The diffuse glow filter is one of our favorite filters to apply. It makes an image look soft and angelic. When applied properly, a new image can be made to look aged in a wonderful way. In this example, we applied the diffuse glow filter from the filter gallery and adjusted the graininess, glow amount, and clear amount settings until it produced an effect we were happy with. The result made all of the light source areas of the image appear to glow.
We weren't entirely happy with the full color image, though, so we decided to apply a black and white adjustment layer to the image to make it look more old-timey. We ended up liking the black and white result much better than the full color result. And so if we jump over to Photoshop, I'll show you how we did this. And so, of course, we duplicated our background layer and we made it a smart object. So now if I go to the filter menu and choose the filter gallery, it'll apply our filter as a smart filter. We applied the diffuse glow filter. And then this one is one we didn't use the default settings on. We wanted it to look kind of magical and, what was the word we used, angelic-like. And so when it's grainy, it doesn't appear that way. And so I lowered the graininess setting all the way to the left-hand side so that the grain would be as unnoticeable as possible. I increased the glow amount until a lot of the image was glowing. And then I slid the clear amount back and forth until I found a happy medium to what I was happy with. When we select OK, you can see that result on the screen. Now, we can take it one step further. If I don't want it to be in full color, I could colorize it in a number of ways that we learned this semester, and so I recommend using an adjustment layer. And so on your layers panel, at the bottom of the layers panel, you can select the Create New Filter Adjustment Layer. I like to call it the black and white cookie. And then you can come down till you find black and white, and then by default, it'll apply a black and white filter for you. You could then adjust it if you wanted to. You could choose a different preset from the black and white options, but it makes it look more old-timey and more magical. You could even take it one step further. You could lower the opacity on your black and white layer to allow some of the color to show through. And so now it looks like an aged photo, but maybe it was a color photo that faded over time. And so you could figure out the balance of the settings that you like best for your project.
That looks very cool.
Thank you.